First of all, you're going to want to prime your eyes as per usual. Just take your favourite primer and apply this all over your lids. Then take a black cream base and apply this to the main centre part of your lid and just kind of blend it out with the same brush. You don't have to be neat with this at all, this is just going to create a really, really dark look to the eye. You can use a gel eyeliner for this if you don't have a black base. Then go ahead and take a black matte eyeshadow preferably and apply this all over the lid, and then take the other side of the flat brush and apply this into the crease of the eye. Then very messily take a kind of big fluffy brush and blend this all out just using wiggling motions. You really, really don't have to be neat about this, but if you wanted to, you could just follow a normal smoky eye tutorial if you wanted to, but this is why I created this one. Then if you went too far upwards and just dull it down a bit, you can always take your face powder on a fluffy brush and just dust around the edges. Then for the main part, which really adds the effect, you want to take a red eyeshadow. This one's from Kyolyn, I got this in a makeup kit. Red eyeshadow is usually quite hard to find, but I will link some below if I can find some. Then just blend this all around the edges of the black eyeshadow using a small crease brush. This one's from Real Techniques, it's really small and fluffy, which is really useful. Don't forget to blend it right into the inner corner as well, because you want a really kind of sunken in look. Then take the same black eyeshadow from earlier and line your lower lash line with it. And then blend out the red underneath using the fluffy crease brush for a really sultry, smoky effect. This part looks really painful on camera, but it wasn't, I promise you. Then take some super spidery long eyelashes and apply them for some drama. Then I took a really pale shade of grease paint. You could also just take a really pale foundation if you wanted to, or just apply your normal foundation. It's completely up to you, just what kind of effect you're going for. Obviously, I wanted a lot of drama, so I took a very, very pale, almost white grease paint and just apply this using my Sigma F80 flat top kabuki brush. Then once that all set in, you can apply a translucent powder or just apply a normal face powder on top to set it all. I took my normal face powder as this kind of added a tiny little bit of extra colour so I didn't look so cartoon-like, which I quite liked, or if you wanted to just take the baby powder as well, that also will work. Then you want to take a red eyeshadow from before and just blend this all the way down, because obviously some of the face makeup has taken away some of the blending we've done earlier. Then just go ahead and top up the eyeshadows so they have extra drama. I also took a dark purple eyeshadow, this is by Sketch from MAC, and just fluffed that around the edges as well. Then for your brows, you want super arched brows or even thin ones if you can. I just made mine super arched because I just think that looks more sexy and vampire-like. Then you want to line the inner rims of your eyes with a long staying thick black eyeliner. This one's from YSL, is the one that I find actually goes on the best. If you have any suggestions for really good black eyeliner, please let me know. I just want one that lasts for ages. Then you want to go ahead and do some contouring. You can do this with a grey eyeshadow if you wanted to, but I chose to use this blush from NYX called Taupe because it's kind of that like sort of muddy brown shade, and I just think it looks, I don't know, it just looks really good. And I think if I'm going to use a grey, it'll look too cartoony. And anyway, just use whatever you want. Then I took a red lipstick and applied this to my lips. You'll see in a few clips time that I kind of mucked up a bit and it did go sort of very, what's the appropriate word for YouTube? It's very big lips, basically. But I just kind of went with it and just, yep, here, ready. I just went way too big, but I kind of wanted to roll with it and, you know, I was going to roll with it. I was going to see what I could do. But it's as soon as I applied the black lipstick later on and then blended it together, I actually created this really cool voluptuous lip look. Obviously, it's not for everyday use, and just with the red, it looks kind of weird. Once you apply the black, it just makes this really kind of three-dimensional, big, pouty lips, which is what I could imagine a sexy vampire to have, I guess. So just go ahead, apply the black lipstick, blend it all together, and then I actually loved my lips. Then I took this tattoo, I will link it below if I can find it. Just type in vampire tattoo, and it's really, really useful. Instead of like trying to create realistic looking holes, I just did the lazy method, and then I applied some fake blood and let it drip down naturally to my neck. My necklace is from Amazon. I just typed in vampire necklace, but obviously I will link it down below, and it just adds so much to the look, I think, because it's really gothic looking. And then also apply some to the corners of your mouth and just let the blood drip down naturally. It does tickle so much, so just be warned for that. Also, if you're actually going to wear this out, I suggest applying the blood maybe when you're there, because obviously you might get smudged before photos, you know. So just go with it. Just let it trickle down. It does tickle a lot. But yeah, apply some blood. You can apply some to both sides if you wanted to go super gory, but I just went for one side. That is the finished look. It's super seductive, really sexy vampire, not scary at all. It's kind of scary, but you know, more on the seductive side. And yeah, I really enjoyed making this video, and I shall see you in my next tutorial. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Bye.